Russia, Siberia, Tasunga, 1908, June 30th, 7:17 a.m.
The largest explosion the world has ever experienced. The blast destroyed everything in a 42-kilometer radius. These unsuspecting residents were about to witness something extraordinary.
They saw a
bluish light, nearly as bright as the sun, moving across the sky.
What followed was an estimated 15 megaton explosion, which knocked over about 80 million trees
in a 2,100 square kilometer area, forming a butterfly-shaped pattern. There have been a number of very large recorded explosions. Let's compare the scale of Tunguska versus other major explosions. I will compare the size of the explosions, the area flattened, and the human death toll. First of all, let's explore the explosions measured in kilotons. Nagasaki and Hiroshima were both massive in scale. But next to Tunguska and Krakatoa, they are minuscule in comparison. That leads us to the area flattened. Krakatoa, Hiroshima and Nagasaki were all huge. In the Krakatoa explosion, the whole island was blown up. However, Tunguska covered a larger area overall. But what was the human impact on these explosions? As we can see, Krakatoa, Hiroshima and Nagasaki had tremendous loss of life. Tunguska, however, had zero. Thankfully, the world dodged a bullet with Tunguska.
The damage extended to a size greater than London and New York put together. It also sent a shockwave throughout parts of Europe and Asia, registering as far away as England, which was about 6,437 kilometres away. It was 1,000 times the size of the Hiroshima nuclear bomb. The night sky glowed. It was so bright that people as far away as China and London were able to read in the middle of the night with nothing but the glow of the sky. Here is a first-hand account from Serge Sinov, who was about 84 kilometres from ground zero.
At breakfast time, I was sitting by the house at Vanavara Trading Post, 64 kilometers from the epicenter, facing north. I suddenly saw that directly to the north, over Onkel's Tunguska Road, the sky split in two and the fire appears high and wide over the forest. The split in the sky grew larger and the entire northern side was covered with the fire. After that, such noise came as if rocks were falling or cannons were firing, the earth shook. And when I was on the ground, I pressed my head down, fearing rocks would smash it. When the sky opened up, hot wind raced between the houses like from cannons, which left traces in the ground like pathways, and it damaged like some crops. Later, we saw that many windows were shattered, and in the barn, a part of the iron lock snapped.
The Tunguska event was and still is a mystery. There are lots of theories, some of which, on first inspection, make perfect sense, but they need that final clue to make them definitive. They range from asteroids and comets to things as far-fetched as UFOs. These are the three main theories: the asteroid theory, the comet theory, and the volcanic gas theory. The meteorite theory. Meteorites are known as asteroids unless they enter the Earth's atmosphere. They're made of rock and metal, and therefore are solid. Consequently, they cause damage when they hit the Earth's surface. Did this cause the Tunguska explosion? Not likely, since there was no crater ever found or any heavy metals, and it wouldn't have blown up 8 miles above Earth. The volcanic gas theory. This theory is that molten magma beneath the Earth's surface forced its way up through the Earth's mantle via subterranean volcanoes. For thousands of years, the magma was held back by a thick layer of basalt. Under immense pressure, the gas from the molten lava burst through, creating a gas storm above the surface, which set fire to all the trees. Did this cause the Tunguska explosion? Well, the theory does make sense, but little scientific evidence backs it up. The comet theory. Large shooting stars are also known as comets. Shooting stars are an often occurrence. They are as tiny as sand and made up of dust and ice. As they enter the Earth's atmosphere, they burn, and their tails glow as they burn. This is more commonly known as ionizing. Did this cause the Tasunga explosion? Very likely, since witnesses saw a bluish light and it exploded 8 miles above the Earth. Well, I'm finished my Tunguska documentary. But Tunguska was a warning. We should live every day like it's our last and thank God for our wonderful blessings, because you never know when the next Tunguska is around the corner.
Spend my life